Hi students, so in this video we are going to focus on point of intersection between two straight lines and also the condition for concurrency of three straight lines. So first we will try to derive the point of intersection between two straight lines L1 and L2. So two straight line equations are taken like this. So point of intersection means generally we have to solve both the equations. So as you know that when we are given two straight lines L1, L2, point of intersection of these two lines is definitely going to lie on both the lines. Point of intersection, for example, if you take as P, this point lies on L1 as well as L2. So therefore, Let us assume Px0, y0 be the point of intersection. I'm supposing x0, y0 be the point of intersection of the given lines L1 is equal to 0 and L2 is equal to 0, given lines. So therefore, this point must satisfy both the lines. So I will substitute this point in L1 as well as L2. So substituting in L1. Okay. So substituting in L1, I will get A1 x0 plus B1 y0 plus C1 is equal to 0. So in place of x and y, we are using this point. Okay. Similarly, when we substitute this point in the second line, we will get A2 x0 plus B2 y0 plus C2 is equal to 0. Now, let us suppose these two equations as 1 and 2. Now, solving 1 and 2, we will get the point of intersection. So for solving 1 and 2, we can use different techniques. We can use elimination method, that is eliminating one of the x0 or y0 values, elimination method, normal procedure which we generally learn from our school level. Or we can use crisscross method. So let us do by crisscross method here. So crisscross method, first we will take the coefficients of second term. That means this y0 coefficients. So first y0 coefficients I will write. Next we should write constants. Next we should write first term coefficients in both equations. And again we will repeat second term coefficients like this. Now what are the variables here? x0, y0. So the first variable x0 I'll put here. Second variable y0 I'll put here, and last constant term, always we will use one only. So while we are using crisscross method, the first variable placed here, second variable placed here, in this place we will always write one only, constant place. Okay, now using this crisscross method, we can get the point of intersection like this. First, x0 means the first variable we should write, and crisscross method B1 C2 minus B2 C1. So product of these two minus product of these two. So B1 C2 minus B2 C1. B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Next we should write the second variable y0 by C1 A2 minus C2 A1, product of these two minus product of these two. So C1 A2 minus C2 A1, this is equal to, now we will write this 1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1. So A1 B2 minus A2 B1. Now when we equate these two terms, you can get x naught value clearly. So x naught by this is equated to this, means x naught will be v1c2 minus b2c1 by this. And when we equate these two terms, you will get the value of y naught. Okay, so therefore I can get that x naught will be, equating these two, what will be x naught? b1c2 minus b2c1 by a1b2 minus a2b1. And equating these two, we will get y naught as c1 a2 minus c2 a1 by a1b2 minus a2b1. So this is x naught y naught value. And what is x naught comma y naught? It is our point of intersection. We have assumed the point of intersection as x naught y naught. We got like this. So what is the point of intersection now? X naught is this one. That is what we have to see. We have to prove. Y naught. That is what we have to prove. Okay, so this completes the proof. Point of intersection of the given lines x naught comma y naught is actually proved to be this one. So whenever two lines are given, you can directly solve the lines using crisscross method like this to find the point of intersection, or for our convenience we can use this formula also. Okay, so we have next theorem on board. So this is actually the theorem which gives us a condition for three lines to be concurrent. So we have taken three lines L1, L2 and L3, three lines represented by the respective equations. So these three straight lines are such that no two of which are parallel. So of course the lines are concurrent condition we are proving. So when two of the lines are parallel, means how they can be concurrent? So concurrent means of course they must not be parallel to each other. So no two of which are parallel. Then these lines are concurrent if and only if this is the condition for concurrency of the three lines. Now how to prove that these three lines are concurrent? Basically, when you have three lines, for example, which are concurrent at a single point, then when we actually solve two lines, for example L1, L2, when we solve these two, we get the point of intersection of L1, L2. And the point of intersection of L1, L2 must also satisfy the third line, because the point of intersection is actually on the third line also. When the three lines are concurrent at a single point, the point of intersection of any two lines must lie on the third line. So this is the basic concept we use for proving this condition. Now coming to this concept application, we will take L1, L2 first, and we will solve these two to find the point of intersection of these two lines. So point of intersection of L1, L2 we have just proved in the previous case. So B1, C2 minus B2, C1, that formula we have proved. So the point of intersection of these two I will take directly, because just now we proved it. Now the point of intersection of these two must lie on the third line. So that I can substitute in the third line. Then by simplification we will get the condition. Okay. So what I am starting by is, let x naught comma y naught. Let x naught comma y naught be the point of intersection, I am writing in short, POI, point of intersection of L1 and L2. Okay, then this x naught comma y naught will be B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by a1b2 minus a2b1, c1a2 minus c2a1 by a1b2 minus a2b1. Point of intersection of L1, L2, we just proved this now. Okay, so now this point lies in the third line also. So we can substitute this point of intersection of L1, L2 in the third line because it must lie on the third line. Okay, so now we will write the condition now. If L1, comma L2, comma L3 are concurrent, for example, if L1, L2, L3 are concurrent, then x0, comma y0 must satisfy. x0, comma y0 means point of intersection of first two lines must satisfy L3 is equal to 0 also. Okay, so if and only if the point of intersection satisfies L3 means we will substitute. So this is L3, substitute now A3 in place of x coordinate. So B1 C2 minus B2 C1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1 plus B3 into y. So write the y coordinate. C1 A2 minus C2 A1 by A1 B2 minus A2 B1 plus C3 is equal to 0. Now substituting x0 comma y0 in L3 we get like this. Now take LCM and simplify. So if you take LCM, we will get A3 into B1 C2 minus B2 C1 plus B3 multiplied with C1 A2 minus C2 A1 plus, when we are taking LCM, last term will be C3 into A1 B2 minus A2 B1 is equal to 0. Denominator I am not writing because once you take the LCM, cross multiply, that will be anyhow 0 only. Okay, so now we will simplify this. So this is what we have to get. So when we simplify, so A3 B1 C2 minus A3 B2 C1 plus B3 C1 A2 minus B3 C2 A1 plus C3 A1 B2 minus C3 A2 B1 is equal to 0. Now, just see the proof part. So, how we have actually in the Gehrem theorem, how to get? So, to get this condition, we have to take A1 common in these two terms. See, if we take A1 common, what we get? If you take A1 common, B2 C3 minus B3 C2. That is what we have here. Next, B1. So, if you take B1 common in this term and this term, B1 common, C2 A3 minus C2 A3 minus C3 A2. C1 common in these two terms, A2 B3 minus A3 B2. That is what we have to prove. So therefore, I can write this directly like, just see carefully now, A1 common. In which terms? A1 common in these two terms. So A1 common in these two means, you will get B2 C3 minus B3 C2. So what we have here, directly that only we are getting. So B1 common now. So B1 common in this term and this term. B1 common. So we will get C2 A3 minus C3 A2. Next, C1 common. C1 common in these two. Okay, so A2 B3 minus A3 B2. A2 B3 minus A3 B2 is equal to 0. And this is what we have to prove. Now, to actually remember the condition, we have another technique. To remember the condition, actually, we use this technique. For remembering, this is same as determinant of A1 B1 C1, A2 B2 C2, A3 B3 C3 is equal to 0. So this is better actually to remember, because A1 B1 C1 is nothing but coefficients of first line, next coefficients of second line, next coefficients of third line. So very easy to remember actually. And when you expand the determinant, you will get this only. See, A1 into B2 C3 minus B3 C2. Next, minus B1 into A2 C3 minus A3 C2. You have to take minus common to get this. C1 into A2 B3 minus A3 B2. This is same as the value of this determinant. So remember the formula, this is better. So whenever three lines are concurrent, we can use this formula as the condition. So first row represents first equation coefficients, second row represents second equation coefficients, and third row represents third equation coefficients. Okay, so let us solve a problem based on this now. So let us take an example. Using that condition for concurrency, find the value of k if the lines, three lines they have given, are concurrent. So three lines are concurrent, some unknown value k they have put here that you have to find. Okay, so I will use the easiest formula to remember. So given lines are concurrent. Given lines are concurrent, which implies determinant of A1 B1 C1, A2 B2 C2, A3 B3 C3, this determinant is 0. Okay, so how to apply the formula? So determinant of this first row represents coefficients of first line. What are coefficients of first line? 2 minus 3k. Second row represents coefficients of second equation. 3 minus 4 minus 13. Third row represents third equation coefficients. 8 minus 11 minus 33. So this determinant is equal to 0. Expanding determinant and simplifying, we will get the value of k. Okay, so now let us expand the determinant from first row. So using first row now, 2 into, remove this row, this column. So therefore 33 into 4, that comes to 132, 132 minus 13 into 11. Okay, so minus 13 into minus 11, that means plus only, no? So minus 13 into 11, that means minus 143. Next, minus 3 into, remove this row, this column. So therefore, minus 99, 3 into minus 33, minus of, minus 13 into minus 8. So therefore that becomes plus 13 into 8, I should write. So 13 into 8 means it is 104. Next, plus k into, so remove this row, this column, minus 33, minus 33, minus minus 32, that means plus 32. So this is equal to 0. Okay, so now let us simplify. So we will get 2 into, so this is minus 11, minus into minus plus 3, 104 minus 99 means 5, plus k into minus 1, that is equal to 0. So minus 22 plus 15 minus k is equal to 0. So I'll shift to minus k to that side. So minus 22 plus 15 minus 7, minus k shifted to right side, you will get k. So k is equal to minus 7. So this is the value of k for which the given three lines are concurrent. So here is the next question. Find the point of intersection of the lines. Two lines are given. You have to find the point of intersection of these two lines. So let us try to write both the lines in standard form, that is ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 model. So if I take the first line, so for example I will take the first line as L1, take LCM, we will get bx plus ay is equal to ab. That means minus ab is equal to 0. So if I take the second line L2, so take LCM, we will get ax plus by is equal to ab. That means minus ab is equal to 0. So we can solve these two lines to get the point of intersection. So for solving, we can use different techniques like elimination method, or directly we can solve using crisscross method, or we can solve using, or we can use the formula of point of intersection. The point of intersection of these two straight lines formula already we have derived in this video itself. So directly we can use the formula also. Or I can use crisscross method for finding the point of intersection. Okay, let me use crisscross method. So first I will write second term coefficients. Next I will write constants. Next I will write first term coefficients. Next again second term coefficients we will write. What are the variables here? X, y. So first variable I'll put here, second variable I'll put here, and at last we will always put one only. Okay, so now we can write this as x, y, crisscross method. So a into this one minus b into this one. So a into this one, what you will get? Minus a square b minus into minus plus ab square. So this is equal to y by product of these two. That means minus a square b minus b into minus ab. That means plus ab square. That is equal to 1 by b square minus a square. Now equating these two terms and these two terms separately, we will get x is equal to, if I equate these two terms, what I will get? X is equal to minus a square b plus ab square by b square minus a square. Let me simplify this. So in the numerator, I can take ab common in the numerator. So ab common. First term minus a, second term plus b. Denominator, I can write this as b minus a into b plus a. So that is actually a square minus b square model. So this b minus a, I can cancel. What is left now? Ab by b plus a or a plus b. This is the x coordinate of the point of intersection. Similarly, when you equate these two, we will get the y coordinate of point of intersection. So equating these two, minus a square b plus ab square by b square minus a square. Same technique we will use. Numerator ab common. Ab common means first term minus a, second term plus b. Denominator b square minus a square can be written as b minus a into b plus a. So this b minus a part I can cancel. So ab by a plus b is left. So this is the x coordinate, this is the y coordinate of point of intersection. So this is the standard model which we have to remember actually. The point of intersection of lines in these models is always ab by a plus b, comma ab by a plus b. So one more point I want to discuss is, when three lines L1, L2, L3 are given, when three lines are concurrent, we can write this condition, lambda 1 L1 plus lambda 2 L2 plus lambda 3 L3 is equal to 0. When three lines are known to be concurrent, then the given lines can be put in this model, where lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are some real numbers which are non-zero. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 are some real numbers which are non-zero. So if we can put the three lines in this model, then the lines will be concurrent. So for concurrency of three lines, we can even use this condition also. Okay, so let us conclude here now.